This video covers installation of a Strutmaster's front suspension conversion for 2006 to 2011 Cadillac DTS models. Before we begin working on the vehicle, we want to shut off the power to the entire system for safety reasons. The battery is located underneath the back seat. You'll want to pull up on the front edge of the back seat and flip it out. Now you'll disconnect the ground wires from your negative post on the battery to shut off all power to the vehicle. Now you're ready to safely raise the vehicle to a good working height using an approved lifting device. Now we're ready to remove one of the front wheels and get started. General Motors Corporation completed its purchase of Cadillac in 1909, and Cadillac quickly became GM's brand of prestige and focused on producing larger, more refined vehicles. Cadillac rolled out its first automobiles, the Runabout and Tonneau, completed in October of 1902. They were basically horseless carriages with a 10 horsepower single cylinder engine. Okay, back to our installation. We're now ready to disconnect the connector at the back of the magnetic strut. You'll move the wire out of the bracket and out of your way for now. Next, you'll disconnect the ABS sensor from the back of the hub and pull the wire and bracket out of the way. Did you know that Cadillac was named for a Frenchman? Antoine Lemay de Lamothe, Sieur de Cadillac. Pardon my bad French. He founded the city of Detroit in 1701. Of course, most of the Cadillacs are famous for being made in Michigan during their 47-year run of the DeVille, but some were actually made in New Jersey and California. Once we've disconnected the ABS sensor from the back of the hub and got it out of our way, our technician is going to use a 10-millimeter socket or wrench to remove the bracket at the top of the strut. Make sure you keep the bolts and the bracket to use later when we break out our new Strutmaster strut. If you're watching this video and trying to determine whether this is a job you want to tackle, or if you'd rather find an approved installer, we can help you either way here at Strutmasters. We've got a dedicated team on our tech line at 866-998-8737, or you can get one of our suspension experts on our sales team a call at 866-597-2397, and they can help you find an installer in your area. Now we're ready to disconnect the ride height sensor. It's located near the bottom of the A-arm. All you'll need is a small pry bar or a large screwdriver to pry the ball from the socket to disconnect it. Now you're ready to loosen the two lower nuts on the lower strut mount. You'll need a 24-millimeter socket and a 21-millimeter wrench to loosen those two lower strut bolts. But don't take them all the way off just yet. As you can see, our technician using the 24-millimeter socket and 21-millimeter wrench. And before you take them all the way off, he's going to take a hammer to the end of the bolts just to break them loose a bit. He'll use the hammer to break them loose just a bit to make them easier to get off later. Before we take them off, you want to place a jack or an underhoist lifting stand underneath the hub for additional support once the strut is removed. Now that you've got some extra support in place, you can finish removing the lower strut bolts. While you're putting on your Strutmaster's conversion system, keep in mind, we have a tech line at 866-998-8737. where our customers have access to a real ASC certified technician. We have good detailed instructions, but if you do hit a snag during the installation, we're here to help. You can use a pinch or just a skinny extension, and that'll help you drive them all the way out if they're stuck. There'll be some tension on those, so that's why we're using in this shot the extension and a hammer to tap them loose. Once the bottom part of the strut is completely loose, it's now time to disconnect the upper strut mount bolts, and you'll need a 15 millimeter socket to do the job. We recommend completely removing the back two and just loosen the front bolt and leave it in for now. We appreciate you choosing Strutmasters, and we're always cooking up something new. Like us on our Facebook page to see our latest videos, news, and information. At this point, you'll want to reach in and slightly pick up on the strut with one hand, and then you'll remove the final top strut bolt and gently lower it. Now you can safely remove the strut. This will be a great time for you or your mechanic to inspect the other front suspension parts for excessive wear, like tie rod ends and ball joints, for example. Worn out parts tend to be more noticeable with a passive suspension. Okay, remember the electrical connector that plugged into the bottom of the strut? Now we're going to find that and we'll prepare to install the electronic resistors included with your Strutmaster's conversion system. Our technician is going to cut the connector from the wire. And then he'll strip back the two wires enough to crimp them on the two resistors included in the conversion kit. Keep in mind it doesn't matter which way they connect since there is no polarity in the wiring system. When you're done, just move the wire out of your way for now. Now you're ready to put in your new fully assembled Strutmaster's passive strut. Once you've taken the bolts off the top, you're going to put it up in there and line up the bolt holes at the top of the strut tower and get the rear stud bolted up. We'll start with that rear stud and get a bolt on it and just finger tighten it to hold it in place. You can put on the remaining bolts and just leave them loose for now. Now it's time to line up the bottom of the strut. Adjust your lower jack if needed, and you can use a screwdriver or small pry bar to help line up the bolt holes. The Cadillac DTS stands for DeVille Touring Series. The DeVille model officially started in 1958 and ran through 2005, spanning 8 generations of chassis platforms. Remember, you're going to need the 24 millimeter socket and 21 millimeter wrench to tighten the lower bolts. The name DTS was used by Cadillac for the first time in 1985 when a DeVille Touring Series package was offered. Once our lower strut bolts are tightened, we'll be ready to reattach the brake line bracket to the strut using a 10 millimeter socket or wrench. You'll find the upper bracket and bolts we saved for the old strut and bolted up to the other side of our new strut. As with all of our conversion systems, Strutmasters recommends getting a four-wheel alignment on the vehicle right away to ensure even tire wear. And once that's completed, we're ready to clip the ABS sensor wires back onto the bracket. The electrical connector wire also clips onto the bracket, and we'll use a zip tie to keep the electrical connector wire out of the way since it's no longer needed. Just a little snip to remove the excess, and we're ready to move on to our next step, which will be to reattach the height sensor. Remember, the height sensor is located near the bottom of the A-arm. To reattach the height sensor, you're simply going to snap the ball back into the socket. Once that's completed, it's now time to tighten the bolts at the top of the strut tower using a 15 millimeter socket. And don't forget to tighten all three. Now you can remove any screw jack, under hoist stand, or floor jack used to support the hub, and you're ready to put back on the wheel. If you decide this is too tough a task for you, don't worry. Ask one of our suspension experts by calling 866-597-2397, and we may be able to find a preferred installer close to your area. Strutmasters recommends using a torque wrench to torque the lug nuts to factory specs. We recommend consulting your owner's manual to find the correct amount of torque for your specific vehicle's lug nuts. And once you've got them tightened down, you're done with that side of the vehicle. You'll simply repeat the process on the other side of the vehicle using the same step. Once both sides are done, you can reconnect the ground wires to the negative post on the battery located under the rear seat. Reinstall the rear seat, and you are ready to ride. If you have further questions or need technical support about this Cadillac DTS installation, you can give our tech team a call at 866-998-8737. Or if you haven't ordered your parts yet, call one of our suspension experts at 866-597-2397. 2397, and we're always here and ready to help.